and the uncertainties that we share. In spite of political mindsets that might drive us apart, could we find middle ground? Could the growing discord between our citizens and their government be repaired? Would we, as elected leaders, choose serving the people over serving government? Yet none of us could have foreseen just how much we would be asked to overcome. The riots and lawlessness that threatened to tear Baltimore City apart. For me personally, a life-altering diagnosis requiring me to publicly wage what is normally a very private battle. And last week, an historic winter storm had left a season's worth of snowfall in just 2 days. Together, we have been tested. But in the face of adversity, we were not Democrats or Republicans looking back. We were Marylanders with our eyes fixed forward, working together for a better tomorrow. By working together, we have put Maryland on a new path, and we are changing Maryland for the better. I want to extend my sincere thanks to your presiding officers who have risen up to help us meet the challenges of the past year. Speaker Bush, our state's longest serving speaker, is a man who strongly believes in sound policy to achieve good government. Thank you. which will improve the lives of those who need it most: working families, retirees, and small business owners. Last year, we introduced tax relief on retirement income for veterans, and with the support of this assembly, we passed it. This year, we ask all of you to work with us again to extend this exact same tax benefit to all of Maryland's retirees. For working families, let's deliver on a popular bipartisan issue and accelerate the earned income tax credit. Solving our state's fiscal problems. We've seen a jump in tax revenues not because we raise taxes, but because we're growing our economy. Revenues are now $150 million higher, and we have already eliminated 90% of the $5.1 billion structural deficit that we were faced with at this time last year. Environmental groups, and we hammered out a compromised phosphorus management solution that every not have happened without your help and cooperation. This year, we are investing $53 million for the Chesapeake and Atlantic Coastal Bay Trust Fund, the highest level of funding ever since it was established. This marks the first time in state history that funding dedicated specifically for the restoration of the Chesapeake Bay is not being diverted to the general fund. Maryland should be leading the charge in protecting our environment. Maryland's environment can and should be cleaner and healthier. Let's continue to work together to make that happen. And let's also come together in a spirit of bipartisanship to protect that most fundamental right of every American citizen, the right to free and fair elections. In Maryland, we have the unfortunate distinction of being the most gerrymandered state in the entire nation. We created a redistricting reform commission to fight for the nonpartisan drawing of district lines, something that nearly all Marylanders are strongly in favor of. We ask you to join with us in that fight. Join me in thanking Lieutenant Governor Rutherford and the members of the Maryland Heroin and Opioid Emergency Task Force for their countless months of hard work. This group. entire country was witness to the events that shook Baltimore last April. But when those dark days ended and peace was restored, we knew that the work of healing and revitalizing Baltimore was just beginning. Over the past few months, we launched school to career opportunities for Baltimore youth, improved educational options for college-bound students, $135 million to improve the city's transit system, finally closed down the notorious Baltimore City Jail, began the process of stopping urban blight with a plan to demolish abandoned, decaying buildings throughout the city, and we have been fostering improved economic development strategies, more redevelopment opportunities, and a pro-jobs economic climate.
Change Maryland for the better.
you, and may God bless the great state of Maryland.
Escort peace issue to the Lieutenant Governor and the Governor from the chamber, if you would, please. At this time, we're going to recognize the President Pro Tem of the Maryland Senate. Without objection, so ordered. Senator Maryland stands in adjournment.